But listen, according to my experience, for students, especially the ones who were born and raised in Canada, that means that you probably didn't have the experience of learning grammatical rules in pretty much details, right? So in that case, some students find it a little bit hard to understand or to identify the proper predicate verb in the sentence, all right? For example, let me give you one example. The one who looks at me with the contempt is not my real friend. Okay, all right. So yeah, this is a pretty simple sentence. First of all, tell me what is the subject? Jackson. Jackson. What is the subject in the sentence?
I was talking to my dad. Subject?
Uh-huh.
The one.
Very good. What is the predicate verb?
Looks.
Yeah, okay. Thank you for giving us a very typical wrong answer. Okay? All right? What's your second choice of predicate verb?
I don't know.
There's another verb, only two verbs in a sentence. One verb, the other verb, right? So if looks is not a predicate verb, then must be the is. Okay, listen, guys. Okay, the key is the main reason you should understand the looks is actually not the predicate verb in the whole sentence because there is a word who in front of the looks. Who makes this sentence become the dependent clause, right? So actually, looks is the predicate verb in the dependent clause, but not the predicate verb in the real sentence. See my point? Got it? All right. So usually, for students who mistakenly got the grammar question wrong, especially the grammar regarding the tense, it's not because you don't know, but because you are trapped by the wrong predicate verb you identify in a sentence. Why you identified it wrong? Because you only focus on the predicate verb in the dependent clause. So my meaning is, so my point is usually, okay, once a verb actually is after, for example, the verb, is in the dependent clause. Actually, the marker for you to identify a sentence as dependent clause, because you see some words like who, which, where, say where, and also that, right? Or even whom, right? So if any sentences with a verb here after the words like who, which, where, and then you know that's not really the predicate verb. In that case, when you decide the major tense of this sentence, you don't look at this verb, all right? You have to look at the, this is my language, I call is the naked verb. For naked verb, because there is nothing in front of this verb. So, because you know, is actually is not in any dependent clause at all. In that case, we know is the real predicate verb of the whole sentence. Make sense? All right. So that is just it. Listen, guys, you have to be able to identify the subject and then predicate verb in the whole major sentence or dominant sentence in the long one. Because first of all, you can know better about the tense in the sentence. Number two, when you come across a long, compound, complex sentence, sometimes sentence might be confusing to you to understand the real meaning from the author. In that case, after identifying the subject and the predicate verb of the real sentence, you can understand the dominant meaning expressed by the author. Make sense? All right. So my point is this sentence actually can be shortened as the one is not my real friend. That's it.